Okay, let's begin. Meeting come to order. I move we approve the minutes for August 29th.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Yeah, okay, so they're approved. Number two, scheduled appointments, Adelia Bardwell, use of town hall. Adelia?
Yes, the Historical Society has come to a point where it's difficult for us to have our meetings in our center school because of the handicap setup. And we've come here occasionally, but we're very well aware that this is a public building for the town offices and boards. So we would request permission to use the town hall meeting room for our monthly meetings so that we wouldn't have to have a conflict here.
Sounds fine.
No, it's public building too, I don't care.
Yeah, and as long as there's no longstanding conflict with something else, I...
Right. I mean, a lot of non-governmental organizations use it for a variety of reasons.
So that building is still heated, I guess, right?
Yeah, yes.
Plumbing is still working in there, okay.
Oh, you mean, wait, Adelia, you want to use the plumbing too?
Oh, well, it might be.
That's a bit outrageous, don't you think?
Yeah.
I'd give your money back for the porta pot, you could put a porta pot out there.
You need that 5 gallon bucket's gone out back?
They may be there still.
I'm fine. As long as you put sawdust on it.
Yeah, that's fine, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm fine too. I'm good. Thank you.
Just make sure the water's not running when you leave.
I don't need any more estate before I leave.
All right, public comments, since they're already commenting. Any more comments from the public? All right, you had your chance. Four, old business. Discuss draft special town meeting warrant articles.
Okay, this will bring us to, I'd like to jump around a little bit through the draft warrant article because we have folks that are here to talk about two of the articles.
Oh, good, okay, yes.
And the first one would be draft article on the bottom of page three. And that has to do with the purchase of the Sanderson property that's adjacent to the school. In your packet, you will have a letter from the superintendent dated October 7th with a recommendation that the town of Whately pursue the purchase of the Sanderson property adjacent to the Whately Elementary School building. We talked about this a little bit at the last meeting, but we didn't really come to any sort of resolution as to whether this is something that the town would want to pursue and whether we'd want to pursue it at the upcoming special town meeting, which will require an appraisal between now and when the warrant closes. So I guess I'm looking for direction as to how we want to proceed with that, if we want to proceed at all.
I'm fine with it. Did we get a purchase price?
Not yet.
Well, okay. I struggle with approving.
We know what it's, I can...
Small market?
I can tell you what it's assessed at, but...
$900.
$900.
$974, something like that.
All right, well, since it's insignificant, I'm okay with it. The one question that I had, and it is only tangentially relevant to the actual purchase of the facility or the land, is I'm still looking for some professional estimate of how a bunch of trees, or if they do, protect the school from the dust and the pesticides. Because I'd love for someone to tell me that they do, but I'm not convinced that it is an effective barrier.
Isn't that separate from then what this article is?
Well, but...
I mean, are we going to buy it anyway?
No, because it says, yes, but
trees
it says,
or not?
But Fred, it says such portion of expenses and compensation of such committee. No, it doesn't say that. I'm sorry. No. It is in another...
Just
where's
the land.
Where's the...
The letter recommends tree planting.
Right, that's what it is.
And I would say that given the potential use, either as a buffer or a site for possible solar collectors for the school.
Yeah, I'm all for that.
Parking lot.
Again, I'm just not convinced that the trees.
I'm not
do
either,
anything.
But that's a separate issue. So I think we should go for it.
As long as it doesn't say we're buying it just to put trees on, but that doesn't say that yet.
I don't think our options have been foreclosed. We have possibilities. And
I'm fine with it.
That we wouldn't have if we didn't have the land, so let's...
Okay, so the next step would be to get an appraisal and get, and have it on the special town meeting board.
Will we have it by then?
We should be able to get it by then.
Okay.
Okay, so I think we're... Do we need to make a motion?
Probably.
Yeah.
I move.
Well, okay.
John moves. We don't approve these until the November 14th meeting, right? So approve the whole warrant article, so do we need to act on each one?
Probably not.
No.
Not this evening.
But the school should be comfortable in the fact that we will support it when we vote on it.
That's all we have to say.
All right, good.
Thank you.
Well, I have one question, and that's for you, sir. What are the alternatives besides tree, a fence?
I don't know.
I mean, let's use common sense here. We're intelligent people. You got trees or a fence, I think that's your alternative.
Right, I'm just not, and I'm all for trees being planted, I just don't want to pretend that it's going to be this huge barrier. I'm just not sure a barrier is, unless it's a really tall fence. I'm just saying, I'm not convinced that a barrier does any, that the trees will do anything. I think the trees are great because, you know, driving to that school on a regular basis, you didn't realize the trees in the barn were there.
Right.
It just was sort of whatever. So I get what you're saying, Don, I'm just saying, I don't think we should pretend...
But I don't know who you get to tell you that answer, because you said we should get a professional, who?
No, somebody who knows what I'm talking about. I'm just saying that let's not kid anybody.
Well, you started the meeting that way, you said...
No, but Don...
A professional.
Don, I'm saying, let's not kid anybody that the trees create this barrier to the dust and the pesticides and the...
Well, I think it'll help, I mean, I'm not an expert.
They may or may not, we don't know, that's my only point.
What did the insurance company say they would pay, just for the trees or a barrier or anything else?
They would pay for the reestablishment of the screening.
So the screening, they said.
And it could be any type of screening.
The assumption in our conversation was that it would be trees.
All right, whatever.
And I'm fine for planting the trees, I'm just not...
I don't want to argue about it, but what I'm saying is that I don't know who you call to get that answer, you know?
And maybe it's not...
And I want you to stand up on town meeting floor and say that.
But I don't...
And I'm going to say the same thing I'm saying right tonight.
But I don't want anyone to also pretend that they create this tremendous barrier when we don't know that they do. That's my only point.
Paul, just as a point, when we decided to purchase that land, to put that school there, and all the back and forth regarding farmers and what they were putting in the soil and what was going to end up in the air, putting trees there was one of the points, was one of the selling points...
Right.
Of putting the school where it is.
But he doesn't think that works, so...
Well, no one has ever proven that it does. But beyond that, I thought we had an agreement with whomever is farming that land that they would not be putting pesticides down while the kids were outside. I thought that was in place.
Likewise, but worth revisiting.
But that is, but I thought that was, it may not be in black and white, but I'm pretty sure it was a very strong handshake.
Well, the problem with that is that I think it's new people using the agriculture there.
Yep.
So it's a different farmer. So any agreement that we had or may have had, I don't think...
Well, somebody's got to pick that ball up.
But it may be a fair discussion to have in terms of our, I don't know if it would be zoning or whether it would be the health board, the Board of Health. But it probably shouldn't have, we probably shouldn't have pesticides blowing around when the kids are...
And I, you know, I think a good farmer's not going to spray any pesticides on a windy day.
Mark.
Waste it, yeah.
But you still have the wind, dust and stuff blowing in the air.
Yeah, I understand.
All right, well, why don't we go back to... Take that under consideration and look into it.
Why don't we go back to the school and ask them what they would think that would be effective to protect...
We are a school right here.
Okay, well, what do you think would be effective?
I think the trees are an effective barrier. Plus, you're going to have a further setback if you purchase this land. So, I mean, I don't know what else you could do.
I think Keith consulted with Franks. He had a specific type of pine. It wouldn't grow branchy on it. It would stay low, 10, 12 feet high can fill in to be as best as it can be as the tree barrier, which is way better than anything that's there now.
Oh, because nothing's there.
Right.
I think the varieties are the one that are nice and tight, and they'll go.
Yeah.
Right.
Nice and tight this way.
I think we should pursue a discussion, at least, or a fact finding about how we go about not having pesticides placed on that land when kids are in the school. I think that's a very valid request.
I agree.
Maybe we have a conversation with the Agriculture Commission.
We got them right here.
We got half of it over here.
Well, but it should be a conversation with the Ag Commission, because the Ag Commission is a representative of the farming community in town.
Is that going on now? Or you don't know?
Is what going on now?
That conversation.
When kids are out at recess,
oh, no idea.
Do we have anybody farming that land, putting stuff down that's going to get into the air?
No idea, but to Dan, or somebody's point, who farms that land is potentially always going to vary, because I think it's rented land.
All the corn here this year to the back of the school to the right is all plowed under because it was full of bugs, so I don't think they use many pesticides.
Pesticides.
Well, thank you, over there this year, because they plowed it all under.
Okay, well, it's something to be considered, so maybe Brian can do some digging.
Yeah.
But meanwhile, we'll get the land.
Yeah.
And, or we'll propose to get the land.
Yeah.
See what town meeting wants to do.
Good.
What's next?
Thank you. The second one is actually on page 2, and that the third one down. And that's a question. Let me back up for a second. Since our last meeting, the water district and the water commissioners had a meeting at which they talked about potential solutions to connecting the two systems. And you know, Fred was there as well. And what came out of that meeting was, can I call it a proposal, is that right? A proposal whereby the district would pay part of the costs, and the town or the water department would pay part of the costs. And for the immediate term, for our purposes tonight, it was proposed that the engineering costs to design how the systems would be connected would be split between the water district and either the water department or the town as a whole.
Whether proportionally, that, or what's the division go?
I believe we had talked that it would be done, that it would be split in half. Is that correct?
That is what we talked about. Subsequently, we've looked at our finances, and we had a feeling like if we came up with $20,000, it would leave us with a really small cushion for any repairs, problems that we ran into in the near future between now and connecting to the town system. So we might suggest the district put in a little bit less than that.
Were you able to get any estimates from the engineer?
I have nothing written from the engineer.
Okay.
I had a conversation with him on the phone where I don't know how much research he had done on the numbers he was coming up with, but he said he thought roughly $30,000 to do the design work, and then some more on top of that if we wanted to do construction management and permitting for the project.
So this comes down to, let's say the whole town paid for it, be about $30 a household.
For the engineering.
And, you know, I could afford $30 even though I don't get any benefits, and there are a lot of us in West Whately who don't get any benefits, but we pay for the other water system. I think since we're all in the town, we're all in it together. We'd like our neighbors to have the benefit of having a good water system. As long as if we run out of water, we come down and get a glass or something.
Scott? Not to be argumentative, but just to put on the record that all town residents would get some benefit from this because of the town buildings that would give
water.
There you go.
As well as fire protection now. So you got the church, you got the post office, you got town hall, you got the library.
Sure.
You got the center school building as well as the Whately Inn.
I don't think you're being argumentative.
No, just one, I would put it up.
I was ready to go for it anyway.
I think one thing that needs to be done, part of this, and I don't know if there's enough cost involved in it here and what would be included under engineering study, but I think there should be an analysis of the system that's there today. By that I mean the pipes and the connections. I mean, you're hooking up to a system that's what, 40, 50 years, 60 years old. I would think that whoever does the engineering, that's why I say you may need more cost than this, dig up a section of the pipe, take a cross section of the pipe itself and of a connection going to a house or to the library and have that analyzed and see what is the condition of that. I think you need something like that to decide, is it worthwhile to connect the two now or should we look at replacing what's there? And that not only tell you, I think you need that detail analysis other than somebody going with a backhoe and digging a hole and say, yeah, the pipe looks good, there's not much rust, so I guess it's fine. Well, I think that the analysis needs to be what's inside the pipe. Is that contaminated? Is it corroded enough where it's only going to last 10 years and then we're back to putting a major investment in 10 years? I think that should be part of this cost, and I don't know if that's going to be enough to cover that. I think that should be considered when you develop this, if you're using this money to go with an engineering firm in your proposal, that should be specified in there to do that.
I don't have a response to that. I'm not sure about the wisdom of that or not. I think that might be a question for the engineer. That may be a useful approach, and it may be not appropriate. I don't know. I don't have an opinion.
So your suggestion that maybe the town pick up the entire engineering costs, was that what you're suggesting? That would solve a big problem that we have in the district because, you know, we're being asked, we're sort of considering voluntarily putting money into the engineering without knowing whether the actual project will be done. That's sort of a hard sell if we don't know what the total cost of the system is and whether it would get the backing of the town, the finance committee, or town meeting. And so, you know, we were sort of trying to figure out how do we try to vet these kinds of issues ahead of the special town meeting before we commit to the engineering costs. But if the town is willing to cover it, it buys us time to consider this in a logical sequence.
Well, we would, I can only speak for myself, of course, but I think that would be a reasonable proposal for the town to put the engineering costs. And, you know, even let's say it's a go, so those of us who don't use the water directly have contributed. And as you say, there's a positive externality because we all benefit by this because we use common buildings. And then,
Well, and the district's contribution is still there to be contributed when the system's...
That's right. You're going to be paying ad infinitum anyway for user fees, right?
But also the assets that we have.
Right.
The system, once the district dissolves, some of those assets could go towards the costs of implementing the plan.
And whether the money's used for the engineering or whether the excess money you have is used as part of the payment of... It's
implementation.
Right.
Yeah.
It really doesn't matter.
Right. Can this warrant article be written such that it's worded that to pay for... Money would be available to pay for an engineering study with cost... to be determined by the water department and water district, with the share of cost to be determined, without specifying one or the other today? Can we word it that way?
I'm missing there.
Rather than saying we're paying half the cost or all of the cost, just say what the cost is estimated to be, say $30,000, to be shared by the water district and water department.
I believe we need to list a sum, sorry, in the warrant article.
Well, we would put a maximum of, say, $30,000, $40,000, with the funding to be shared by both the district and department.
Are you suggesting that the funding for the engineering being shared between those two, or the responsibility for coming up with an estimate is...
No, the funding be shared between the two, to avoid getting into an argument at, say, town meeting, of, well, should it be half or all, or two-thirds?
Well, I think the proposal that Paul put would be that the town, not necessarily the water department, or the water district would pay for the engineering, and then based on the engineering and the estimates we get from that, we would put together a proposal for a spring town meeting for implementation. At that point, the proposal would include what contribution would come from the department, water department, what contribution from the water district, and what, if any, contribution might come from the town.
Because I have to believe that whatever the water district has in its bank account, because you're going to dissolve, ultimately, if this happens, it would just help offset the costs.
Well, that's after the engineering study is done.
Right. But if they pay for part of it in the engineering study, then there's a lot less money to spread over the implementation.
Yeah, and if the implementation never happens, then we're broke.
Yeah, but I guess I'm not comfortable saying that we're going to pay for all the costs, because there is some, yeah, there's, like you said, benefit to the town entirely, but there's also benefit, and maybe more benefit, to your residents in the center of town.
Well, you could argue they are.
We're not suggesting you pay all the costs. We're suggesting that part of the town costs would be the engineering study. There's going to be plenty of other costs down the way, of which the district will contribute in many different ways.
The district are paying for it, because if let's say to pay out free cash, just as an argument, well, they share our free cash just as much as everybody else.
Sure.
Paul?
Why aren't we treating the individuals in the center of town as we treated the individuals on the east side of town when there was a water problem? I believe the entire town absorbed the cost of that, and consequently there became an enterprise fund, and then they took that over and pretty much pay for it themselves now. Why can't the same thing happen here, and that it becomes incorporated first, so that everything is going to be paid for by the entire community?
You're talking about the engineering thing, or the whole ball of wax?
The whole thing.
Don?
I agree with that 100%. However, you left out one piece.
What's that?
Those of us down in East Whately paid a hookup fee.
It'd be the same thing.
Okay.
Yeah, we've discussed different options that way. We also wanted to make sure that the district was credited for actually providing water to people in East Whately when the emergency happened. And so that, you know, when East Whately was in trouble, the water district also came through with
resources. Where's the other way, too, when you guys ran out of water?
That's right. It's sort of a town-wide issue of making sure everybody gets clean water. And we've had discussions about what the hookup fees should be and how much credit there should be for the infrastructure that's already in the ground. Or whether there could be a differential rate to help pay off the cost of the... So there's a proposal to be made where the district individuals would pay towards that, as well as the district itself. It would be a lot easier to come with that proposal when we have solid numbers after an engineering study.
Why don't we just leave it right now that the engineering costs would be paid for by the town, the whole town, and not try to divide it up here? We're talking $20,000, maybe $30,000 for this engineering cost. Freight over the whole town is like maybe $20 a household, or 30. I don't know.
Well, Paul, am I hearing you correctly? Because I just want to make sure.
Were you encouraging perhaps that we just do the merger before we do all of this, and then just it is part of what the town has to accomplish?
And then every step of the way, it just becomes part of what we have to do to get them water and be part of the entire...
Right. And then we don't have the nickel and dime of who pays for what and who pays for this or that.
Right.
I kind of get that. Just do the merger first.
But you're going to be going through this multiple times.
But if you don't, if people don't want to do that, I mean, if you merge and a good number of people don't want to do that, then what do you do?
Well, it's a town meeting vote when you vote for the merger.
No, I can't speak for everybody who doesn't have water won't benefit by this, and I don't know how many of those there are, but certainly I think most of those people would be happy to help out with the engineering costs and then get a better idea of what future costs might be that might be brought to bear against those of us who don't get water service, how much that's going to cost us to provide our neighbors with water. I think it's fair to ask that question.
I think it's fair.
Sure, that's fair.
But once again, we will be going through this.
Right.
Part of the consideration too, and that with the engineering will help clarify, is that there's going to be one cost to provide water, but there may be additional costs to provide the kind of volume that the fire chief would like to have to fight fires in the center of town. And so,
right,
knowing the balance of those costs and knowing what the options are probably useful going into a town meeting where we ask the town to merge the two.
Sure.
So we're talking, this is 20,000 is half, so are we looking at 40,000 then for the total?
The one estimate that I've seen is from Ty and Bond, that was 33,000 for just the engineering.
So if we could say 40 should cover it then. And then have everybody pay for it. I have to rewrite the article. Well, that's what I think we should do right now.
I think we should too.
And go from there.
I mean, Scott's point is a valid point, that the more data we have when we go to town meeting, the better chance we have of it actually passing. And we've all learned that every time you go to town meeting without data, we get taken to the woodshed.
Yes, we're very familiar with that dynamic. All right.
So the article should be rewritten to say that, assuming we will decide at a later date where the money comes from, whether it's free cash or not.
Yeah.
For the entire engineering cost to be paid for by the town.
Yes.
Okay. Before we leave this article, I'd like to hear from the water department. What are their comments on this? Thoughts on this? Do you have anything to offer? You want to say anything?
Okay.
It's not coming from the beginning.
No news is good news, maybe. Yeah. I don't know. Okay, we're good with that?
Yep.
Okay. What next?
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Well, I guess the question is, I want your opinion. So do you want to go through these articles one by one, or do we want to save this?
Well, are there any other school articles that we can get to?
There's a school article.
Not keep people waiting.
Right.
And that's the first one. I'm sorry. That's not. Well, let's go to the third one on page one.
Which one?
And that is a repurposing of the funds originally allocated to the repair of the East Whately Elementary School. Which you've been requested to repurpose for the move to central office move to Frontier. So that's money that the school currently has, and we're being asked to repurpose that money.
Okay. I guess I asked for what the total cost of the relocation would be and how much other towns are contributing, and you did send me what their total cost for relocation, but I didn't think anything in there was what the other towns were going to contribute. Is there money in the other towns' accounts for this as well?
I believe so. You probably know.
Correct me if I'm wrong, I think there's about $39,000 left in the Blue School Fund from all the repairs over the years that all the towns put into, in easy words. So of the $39,000, we have a portion, whatever our percentage is, of the $39,000 that we're asking for, that you let us take it away from the Blue School and use it. We're going to use the $39,000 on air conditioning systems in those particular offices in the springtime.
The offices in Frontier.
at Frontier.
So the 6,000 is part of the 39,000 we already have in account?
Well, it's probably 6,000 of the 39,000, if that's our portion. And then Deerfield, and then the other three towns make up the other $33,000.
And since you're leaving the Blue School, you want to apply that money to your next?
Yes.
We're using the middle school offices.
As our new superintendent's offices and accounting, everything there. And still keeping up the other school for now, for record keeping and other things right now.
Blue School for record keeping.
Yep.
Because we have space here. As I mentioned.
About 26,000 square feet, right?
Oh, wow.
Maybe more now, since STEMs aren't going to come, right?
Well, we don't know.
Has there been an assessment of what is going to happen to the insurance costs of the Blue School when it's vacant? Because it will go up dramatically.
We looked into that, and we were told that there will be no cost increase because 30% of the building will still be occupied or used. And that use is what is being stored. So if 30% of the building is used or occupied by something, if there's something in there, then the insurance rates will not go up.
Well, that's different.
So that's different from what we heard before.
Yeah. We were hearing that there was no meetings or.
And no people.
Offices, people in there, that it was considered vacant.
There'll be people probably going in there. Oh, maybe once or twice a day, different people to look up. So the most important records will be with the people right there at the new central office. These will be records that we have to keep up to roughly seven or eight years. And we're in the process of cleaning out some older ones, but it takes time and money to get rid of older records too, so.
There's also employment records that we need to keep in perpetuity, we need to keep forever. Someone just remarked that a person that was going in for retirement had worked in this district for a couple of summers, and that actually added to this person's retirement, and they had to go back to the 60s to find out the exact employment dates. And we do have employee records going way back to at least World War II.
No one's doubting me to.
Yeah, we were just under the impression that it would be much more expensive than the insurance cost might be.
And we've also looked at if for some reason the boiler went, we figure a way of just keeping where our records are stored, heated in one way or another. That's the main thing is, we don't know when things are going to break and whatever is over there, like the boiler would cost a small fortune. Yes, that's one.
You're going to have to replace it at some level for you to maintain, climate control records.
Yeah, it's, put it this way, where are they going to go? It's going to be better where they are now.
All right, well.
That's what I can tell you.
Okay.
That's the only other related to the school, except the first one is we have a student in Crackwell Street. We have a student without a permanent residence, so a homeless student who had moved into Whately. And under the McKinney-Vento law, the town is responsible for half of the transportation costs. So that's the first one.
Nothing you can do about the odds.
Not sure what you can do about it.
Okay.
That's the only other tangential related to the school. Thank you.
Thank you.
The only other issue maybe with the school is the Green Communities Grant, to consume that money so that we can apply for another Green Communities Grant. The school's sitting on, I think, another $70,000 or something.
No, I don't know where we have.
I thought that was moving forward, no?
There's a proposal to, you were going to use part of it to upgrade the technology or computers and whatever.
$70,000 to upgrade the technology in the HVAC. And then some more for lighting.
But there's still half of that left, half again.
I mean, no, it won't be half left, but there'll be
some.
I think it was $130,000 to be
Right, so 60, you know, 50, 60,000.
But I did email Pat Kavanaugh and Bob Wesco today. I haven't heard back. I wanted to get a status.
So a push to use it is we want to apply for another grant, and we can't still.
We have a deadline of December 31st. It has to be used. We talked about, I believe it was lighting. We talked about.
Going to LED. I mean, I think the lights in the school, correct me if I'm wrong, Don, have they been changed at least twice?
I thought they were changed to T8s, right? Fluorescence, thin fluorescence, which are more.
Now everything is LED.
Well, now everything is LED, right. So that would mean changing over fixtures as well as bulbs.
But you'd have to come to us to use the rest of the money for the lighting if that's your desire.
And I'm always a proponent of putting solar electric panels somewhere if you have any money for that left over. Sounds like you won't at this point. But we'll find out, right?
They did provide screening.
Totally agree.
Yeah.
We might have some new property.
Yeah.
I mean, the roof is perfect for solar as well.
But there are trees in front of the
It's southern
building.
Facing. There aren't any trees anymore.
I thought there were trees.
Oh, there's still trees on the
side. I know, I'm kidding.
Yeah. All right, good. Well, keep us abreast
of right.
developments. Cost.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Well, we'll finish off the first page here.
Are we done with schools?
I believe so.
Well, maybe they want to stay. I have actually
a quick question because this money has to be spent by December 31st.
Right.
They need to come, they need a special town meeting to spend the remainder of that money.
Of the Green Community.
Of Green Community.
I don't believe so.
No, they don't?
Community's grant.
Okay. Just our approval.
Yeah, it's Green Community's grant.
Just our approval. No, okay.
And DOER's approval.
Okay, yeah, that's okay.
All right, good.
All right, I just want to make sure they can get spent by the end of the year.
The second article down is to vote to transfer a sum of $10 for unpaid bills to the assessor's office.
Yeah.
Okay. Prior fiscal year.
All right.
Good.
Yeah.
The water department's still here. Our related to the water department, the one on the top, this is on top of page two, just over $5,000, just changed between accounts. Mm-hmm. Was left over in the account for waterproofing mm-hmm. the storage tank, moved that to maintenance management account.
Yep.
And underneath that is a transfer of the sum of $25,000 from the water department. Retained earnings to manganese management to pay for engineering and design of the manganese system.
Yep.
You guys have plenty of money in the retained earnings, I assume.
To do that, yeah.
Where does that
about 9,000.
Not much more, though, is what you're saying, Wayne?
9,000.
Okay.
So where does that stand to do something with the manganese? What's happening? What's happening with correcting the manganese issue? What's the latest?
It went. The application got sent into the DEP. They reviewed it and found 6 or 7 things that they wanted changed on it. So now we're just waiting to hear back from them and the engineers again if they got changed or not.
Are the engineers, and we talked about this in the last meeting, are the engineers and the DEP actually working together on this, or is there lack of communication? Because
I would say probably lack of communication.
We talked about this last time, that we've been through this before with the Mill River issue with the wellhead, and it frustrates me that
the engineers, we're hiring the engineers to make sure that things go smoothly, and it doesn't seem like the engineers are doing their due diligence with the DEP. They're just saying, here DEP, now you tell us what you think, rather than working with them ahead of time to know whether they're going to bless or not bless the study or the plan. And it sounds like we're going down this path again. So how do we get these guys to get in the same sandbox together?
Right. It's, you know, if I don't know what our contract is with the engineers, but, you know, they're dragging this out. I hope it's not costing us more money.
because they're billables. Every time the DEP goes back and says, you need to do these seven or eight more things, that's billable hours.
And those are expensive hours.
So I don't get this.
So who's talking to the engineers from our side?
I mean, I've been in contact with them in terms of the contract stuff, and you've been in touch with them in terms of the pilot study.
The pilot study. Yeah. So you guys need to coordinate.
Yeah.
I would say.
My impression is a little different. I think they are working with Mass DEP.
You do?
Yeah. Well, at this point they are, but to your point, I mean, they submitted a pilot study proposal that Mass DEP looked at and said we need X, Y, and
right.
Z done.
Why didn't the engineers know that was going to be the DEP response before it was submitted and work to make sure that what they submitted initially was going to meet the standards of the DEP, and that clearly didn't happen.
Maybe you all could convey to the engineers that we would like to see better coordination, if possible, between the engineers and DEP. Because it seems like to us, and we're not involved in the process, so we can be dead wrong about this. I don't know. Brian seems to think things are a little better than Wayne, so we're sitting here listening to two different things going, well, so, I don't know who's right, but.
Well, at this point, they're communicating because they've had that original submission, and now there's got to be that back and forth as to how do we get this.
All right, and maybe that's pro forma, yeah. Business as usual. That's the way it goes.
Yeah.
So there's no real problem.
Can we stay on top of them on this, though? I don't think any of us want to hear, oh, now there are two more things after the second pilot.
We're still smarting from other experiences,
right?
Engineers.
So
can I just make a comment about this is the second or not third time that we're hearing the same kind of conversation about the lack of communication with engineers and the job site. Pretty soon, I think we're going to throw it back on ourselves and say, who's signing these contracts? And who's looking at the deliverables on these contracts over time? So that these guys know, if you don't bring the DEP on board, you don't get your money.
Yeah.
That's what we need. We need you to make sure the DEP signs off on all this and makes this happen by such a time. If not, we can't give you a check, guys.
That's how you get them to play in the sandbox. Just a comment.
Duly noted.
And reiterate what Wayne had said. So this is the same engineering firm that we got who filed the loan application on behalf of the town. And that was filed on time for the Clean Water Trust for that loan application.
Okay.
At this point,
okay.
The pilot study is still something that's outstanding.
Yeah.
And that needs to get done.
Okay. So is there a timeline for when we're going to get these seven or eight issues resolved or not yet?
Is it 60 days from, I don't remember when the
11th or 12th
The 11th or 12th of December is their deadline? Sorry?
It started from, was it the 11th, the 12th, the 18th, something like that of October. They had 60 days from then.
Okay, so the middle of December.
Okay, so
okay. We'll follow.
We need to keep on it.
Yeah.
All right. Next.
So 1, 2, 3, the fourth one down, and that figures that amount is wrong. But that is, and I'll get the proper payoff amount. That doesn't reflect the current loan payment. But that's the issue as to whether we want to pay out the USDA loan for the town office building. Mm-hmm.
Well, I think we agreed in our joint meeting with the Finance Committee that was the direction that it was going to be taken. So,
right, and if we pay this off, I'm under the impression we can rent the space out to whomever we want.
Yep, that's accurate.
Yes.
Okay.
So we'll talk about where that money comes from later, I guess. And these next two articles are for the purchase and installation of the vault in the town office building. as it's proposed, the $64,000 would come from the Community Preservation Fund Historic Resources Reserve, and the other half would come from the 2016 free cash.
It's a lot of money.
$128,000 for a mall?
Yes.
Can't go on eBay?
I've seen the estimate they got. Lynn shared it with me. There's only one company in all of the Northeast that does this. And I think she's checked with other towns that had similar projects going in, and they're the only one in town, and they kind of went along with what they've been doing, proposing. But yeah, I think that includes everything from A to Z. I mean, not only bringing the vault here, I think it's kind of a freestanding movable vault. It's not attached to the walls or floor or ceiling. It's by itself, and it's self-contained with the air and heating circulation, and it just includes running and wiring and utilities to it, and assembling it too, transferring it, bringing it here and assembling it. That's why it's this price. I guess it's all inclusive, so you don't need to hire somebody else to put it together and make sure it works properly.
Oh, it is what it is. We need it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Next article at the top of page 3. This is a request from the library trustees. They have just over $3,500 remaining that was appropriated for repairs to the roof and gutters and entrance improvements, and they're asking that we repurpose that money or allow them to amend the article to allow them to use that money to make repairs to the kitchen.
Yeah, I guess it's going to cost. That's $15,000 for all those repairs.
So this is written as it's amending the article.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So $12,000 for.
So what's remaining in the account is the $3,530.
What are they actually going to be doing
to the kitchen?
Yeah. Specifically,
what do they say?
He doesn't say here. It says it'll be around $2,500 for kitchen repairs.
Buy a lot of appliances for $3,500, but, well, depending on what grade you get, I guess.
A really good guess, though.
Yeah, could be one stove for that. Yeah.
It could be.
The next two articles deal with the surplus property of the fire department. It requires a special town meeting approval to donate surplus property. So that would be these two articles.
Fine.
Well, we covered the last one, that was the property at school.
It's a big special town.
And the last article here on top of page 4, and it is the last one, is the Whately Affordable Housing Trust Fund article that's being reintroduced.
Wait, I'm sorry, what happened in 9?
We already did that,
I'm sorry.
9 is the,
okay. I'm sorry, yeah.
So 10 is the last one on here, that's the...
Yeah, what was that?
At the request of the Housing Commission to bring back the Whately Affordable Housing Trust Fund in front of the voters.
Is this the complete housing trust?
Yes.
So we're going with that version rather than abbreviated one that doesn't need to be amended?
Yes, there's two schools of thought. One is, if you have a bare bones approach, so this will actually be adopted as a general bylaw. If you go with the bare bones approach to the bylaw, then you can fill in the rest of it with the bylaws of the trust. If you don't want it to be as flexible, then you would mimic the bylaw would mimic the trustee. The general bylaw would mimic the bylaws of the trust. That way it would require town meeting approval. Change.
So any change to this written here would require town meeting approval?
Correct. And that was the approach that was, I guess, was recommended by the Housing Committee.
Lincoln, What do we do with the agricultural trust? Is there a trust for that? Do they?
No trust for that.
So they proposed, you know, with all their study, whatever, we never got that far to do a trust for them.
No, we didn't.
There's no trust.
So is this going to be the only trust in town?
Correct.
Okay.
Well, we're going to do something with the redo of the $1,200 for the town garage, so we could use it to put a foundation or any other potential need.
I don't believe that was carried over from last fiscal year.
Where did it go?
Free cash, I believe. Is that right?
Went back to free cash?
I believe so.
So should we not, Keith has a need to look at the foundation.
Yeah, I'm afraid his needs go beyond looking at the foundation.
Well, no, that's the beginning.
Yeah, I know.
We start at the bottom.
Yes, he's waiting for annual meeting to do that. I know. Has there been any requests? So this doesn't include any requests for CPA funding.
So I believe the CPA has a meeting November 2nd.
Right, there is one that was approved in the off cycle, and I realized we forgot that. So there's an APR that will be on here. So it's just the two. It's the APR and the vault.
We're going to need more APRs.
For the next round, there could be. I don't know.
Okay, the vault. Okay, vault is on there. Okay.
Is that the one on Christian Lane? That's the APR.
I have to go back and look.
Because I didn't know hear about the CPC APR on Christian Lane. And I assume we would hear back. Definitely after their November 2nd meeting, because I believe they might have comments about the housing trust as well. So.
No, this was approved back in Thursday.
They've already approved it?
They've already approved it.
We'll add that to
it. Yeah, I'll get that to
you. Okay.
Okay.
So that covers that. Again, we have the meeting scheduled for November 9th, a joint meeting with the Finance Committee to review this in greater detail with the Finance Committee.
Good.
Talked about Sanderson property purchase, snowmobile use of...
that's fine. I think. Do you guys see the note from Carl?
Yes.
The same thing he had last time.
Yeah.
Yep.
We do have proof of insurance.
That's fine.
On behalf of the Whately Snowmobile Club.
Good.
We can submit that.
They do have monthly insurance.
Oh, they need some snow. Yeah. Frankly, I can wait.
What are they saying tonight? Awesome.
So that's okay?
Yep.
It's okay. All right.
Town property, sidewalk, snow, mess removal. There's a proposal from
Bill Smith.
In fact, Bill Smith.
It's okay to be on.
I believe it's the same as last year.
Same as last year.
Yep. Any good with that, John?
Yep, okay.
Town hall ramp, library, center school.
Notification of free cash. Duly noted.
You have it in your...
Yep.
Packet there. $590,000.
It's a nice number.
Free cash. And the $1.2 million that the receipts from the sale of the easement, the permanent easement to the cell tower company, were required to put in a special revenue fund. So it is separate and apart from the general fund.
Which is good.
So that has restrictions on it.
Yes, it does.
So, next one?
Yeah.
APR policy approval. This is a policy that you saw probably 2 months ago. And I believe the comment was that it makes a lot of sense and why we're bringing it back. But it needs final adoption by the Board of Selectmen. And this is the APR policy. There's a couple ways to reduce the local match on APR. State pays 80%, local match is 20%. You can have an ag commission, you can have a right to farm bylaw. Another way of reducing the local match, so the state will pay more, is by adopting a policy to the effect that's put before you.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
And it pretty much, to sum it up, it requires a building inspector to check Mass GIS before issuing a building permit. It requires more communication between the town boards, requires the Board of Selectmen to notify the Conservation Commission before waiving the right of first refusal.
I mean, it makes sense.
Yeah.
It looked good.
So we would probably need a motion to adopt that policy.
Motion we adopt.
Second.
Policy is written. Any questions? Any comments from the audience? Okay.
2017 licensing fees.
When was the last time that our licensing fees increased?
2 years ago.
2 years ago?
2 years.
10%.
10%?
And when we booked, I went still here.
No, you can, you, this is more.
Okay.
This is more your bailiwick, so.
When we looked at it last year, we were either high or right on, and so I would not recommend increasing fees at this point in time. We'll look at it again next year.
Sounds okay with me.
Okay.
Fred?
What about the new wine distributor, not wine, the beer, microbrewery?
You mean on Long Plain Road, on Cross Lane?
Do they need a license?
They do not need a license.
They have a farm brewer license.
A brewer license.
Yeah, which is through the state.
Oh, yeah, so what, so a farm brewer's license allows them to do what?
It allows them to do
tasting?
Wholesale.
Wholesale.
It allows them to do retail on-site for off-site consumption. Allows them to
so they can sell bottles to go,
correct,
or cans.
Yep. And they can do tasting on premises.
And they can do tastings. There was a termination by this board that the tastings, that their free tastings weren't a sale of alcohol.
Okay.
So they can do.
Are they open till 9?
We're open right now. Let's go.
All right.
On site, is it?
All right, good. That's fine.
Okay. So do we need a motion for to adopt the license increase?
Motion.
2017.
Second.
Okay. Recreation Committee appointment, Megan Ashman.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
Appointed, right?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So how many does that make now? How many do you have?
That makes six.
Six?
Yeah, with one vacancy, but I'm working on that.
So you moved, I seconded, and we voted.
Yes.
Just for the record.
Shut that camera.
Brian struggles with our...
Town Administrator updates. All right. Highway electrical upgrades. Estimates are due back on Halloween, 10/31/16, with the intent to hire the lowest priced electrician to do that work. Town office build out. We put out the request for written responses and price estimates to do the wall parallel to the windows and a permanent wall behind the town clerk, treasurer clerk, Mary Ann's office. And the lowest bid came in at $14,800.
That's lower than we anticipated, isn't it?
It is. The original estimate we had was 17 and
yeah.
17 and some change, so it was lower than that.
Good.
Okay. Yeah, we'll take into account where the vaults would be going as well.
Yeah.
They're
working
with that, okay.
Yeah, they're actually gonna frame out the header for the door for the vault.
The vault is gonna be on this end?
Yep.
Side, okay.
On this end, yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah, that's taken. Okay. Lynn's seen those. She's working with John.
Okay. Yep. And when do you expect this to be done?
They have a deadline of the end of November, November 30th.
Oh, good.
So we are trying to push hard because we're heating a very large space.
Who's doing the work?
General Contract Solutions out of Southwick. Right at the lowest bid.
Okay.
And the references checked out. Haydenville Mountain Street. Yep. Packed in your letter from the.
I read.
The lowest, yeah. Lanesburg. And my recommendation would be that we submit a letter also.
Yeah.
And I included a draft letter in the packet. I don't know if that's.
I like it.
Response.
I wrote it.
Yeah, you did write it. Are there changes that we want in this letter? I tried not to be as long.
No, it sounded.
And
it
as
sounded,
lengthy as the as
it
the letter.
It was a good tone.
I wanted to take a little bit more of a positive tone.
Sure.
What is the city of Northampton saying? Are we getting anything from them? Is there part?
Are they sending anything? I'm not sure.
We should ask them to. It's a good point.
Good point.
They're gonna carry more juice.
Or send them at least copies of this.
Yep.
Yeah.
So if we're okay with the letter, just want to sign it?
Yeah.
Okay with it?
I mean, the state's not flush with cash, as we know, so it's...
See, I brought a pen for you this time.
Appreciate it. I have a pen, but I don't... Oh, I could have done it.
It just...
Okay, what else?
Grant application, small bridge program grant application. It's due on Halloween again. I've been working with Keith on that, and we're gonna submit.
Good.
There's also a MIIA loss prevention grant we're gonna be applying for backup cameras for the highway department trucks and for body cameras are actually eligible expense on behalf of the police department. So if you're all right with those, we'll submit those, all those grants.
Yeah, go back to the Williamsburg bridges. I thought we were getting two temporary ones from the state at one point. Whatever happened with that? Is that still in the works? And is this grant he's applying for a different location or for the same thing? Or
the small bridge program would be for permanent repairs to bridge that's closed. In talking with Keith, I think his hope was that when the temporary bridge does come through, it might be placed on the bridge further up though.
Yeah.
So we're still gonna get the temporary?
I don't know exactly what it is in the process.
Okay.
We should check on that though.
Yeah.
And I thought it was more than one, wasn't it two or something?
It was two, but it was two. We're gonna get the... Actually, I don't know if it's three total because...
That one bridge was okay and two weren't, wasn't it?
I think it was just two at this point.
Scenario?
Well, certainly the two definitely.
But we gotta follow up on that because it does all work together here. And I could be wrong, but I remember hearing that they're sort of waiting there for us.
Well,
that may be an overstatement a little bit. But
engineering
that may have been
something. Didn't we have to do some engineering work on it? I don't know.
The last item we were waiting.
He said he's going to meet with the engineer yesterday, today. Something.
That was in regards to the small bridge application, grant application.
To the grant application.
Well, is that all that we own? Three of them passed.
That passed the highway bridge, yeah, and then there are three little ones.
Yeah. And that's it. Then it's Bergie.
Then it's culverts.
Oh, but it's culverts.
But we've done some work on one or two of those culverts. I think they're fine.
I think there are seven all the way.
There are seven all the way, but there some of those are not bridges. Technically, they're culverts. There's only those three with railings.
Yeah.
Actual bridges that have abutments.
Hey Brian, can we go, if you're done with the bridge issue?
Yes.
Can we go back to the camera stuff for a second?
Yep.
Are there other camera uses that would fall under that grant?
Like
cameras for Whately.
Like CCTV cameras?
Yeah.
I believe so.
How about the school? Does the school have cameras?
They have cameras already, I think.
They do?
Yeah.
Okay.
Town offices?
What's that?
Town offices.
You know, I just think that, and I know, speaking on behalf of the Rec Commission, that
yeah.
we need to cam up early with trail cams or something. The trash that is left there is ridiculous. People are not taking care of the asset that they're using on at the generosity of the town, and we need things are being left unlocked on a regular basis by a variety of different groups. I was there the other day, and literally not only were things unlocked, but the keys were in the locks, and I don't know whether you guys know that I have somewhat of a temper at times.
Yes.
And it was ridiculous. And I think that having cameras there might get people to take better care of our assets.
Okay.
That would need to be like remotely accessible. How would you use it? Is it just live screens?
No, it would be recorded that you could review.
Yeah.
Okay. You have to actually go there to review it, or could you do it remotely?
I don't know how those cameras work. I'd be curious.
I mean, the constraint we have is the grant is due Friday. So we need vendor estimates by Friday.
Yeah. Okay.
We need for one or two there and see.
Yeah, we got to know how much. But I think the estimate is, you're talking about the cost estimate, correct?
Yeah. Is that what we want to shoot for, or?
Sorry?
Is that something we want to shoot for?
I would like to shoot for it. I think we need, otherwise the rec committee is going to need to pay for it out of our budget, and I'd prefer to pay for it out of a grant for obvious reasons.
Right. Has there been any theft of equipment or anything like that?
No.
Okay.
There's nothing really to steal, but there's the easy option to vandalize.
Yeah.
If people so chose. So there are a number of reasons.
I'm just trying to relate it to, because it's a loss prevention grant, so we need to relate it to.
Well, vandalism is, that's loss prevention, that's damages.
That is, yep.
And we've experienced that in years past, where the receptacles for paper towels have been ripped off the wall, and things like that. And also, you know, all the bathrooms have running water, and it could get, if somebody really wanted to, it could get pricey.
Yep.
I heard Brian Lotke's coming to town for a visit.
Yeah. He can pass by way of it.
So I'll double check to make sure that's eligible, but I think it is.
Thank you.
Yep.
Okie doke.
That's all I have.
I have two quick items. You have time?
Yeah.
One is, okay, the major projects information meeting. I'm going ahead with the November 15th date. I think I've shared with everybody, and it's posted on the website. Most people of the four subject areas have kind of agreed to participate, so I'm working with Brian on getting more publicity out, and like I mentioned, I'm going to plan a one-page handout here on Election Day to inform people that's going on November 15th, and welcome them to participate, so.
Good. It's on my calendar.
That will happen.
Just check.
The other thing, building committee met earlier today we're meeting jointly with the Historical Commission, and we're at the point on the contract with Jones Winslet of developed final plans, or kind of draft final plans, and a cost estimate. We're meeting next week several times. The estimate so far does not look good. And that's why we're meeting next week, to see what we can do about that. It's more than what they've anticipated in the past, the latest version. So I don't know what you guys have any comments on that or not. But
what number might that be?
It's over the 1.45.
How is that possible?
Million. And once you go over that, you need the OPM, the project management.
Oh, yeah. Well, and once you go over that, it's
200,000
to pass.
Yeah. So we're trying to get that number down.
You got it.
We don't know.
I mean, even if you go, even if $1 million of it was CPA money, it's still.
Well, they're looking, or I would say, we're looking at grants. There's, I guess, four grants that are possible: cultural facilities, green communities, CPA funds, and there's, it's not a grant, but, and there's one other one, Mass Cultural, Historic Preservation Fund. So grants could cover, I don't know, maybe two-thirds.
Well, I can recall that, when we were looking at it for the Town Hall project, what, 3-4 years ago now, whenever that was, the cultural grants were in the ballpark of $400,000 alone.
Right.
So if you were to use CPA money, and I'm just hypothetically speaking, if you were to get $1 million in CPA and then $400,000, and that was just one of the cultural grants,
right.
You know, then the town's only on the hook for, you know, if you can get it down to 1.4, I think the grants can cover it. But,
well, yeah, the cultural facilities grant, there's deadlines next month to get at least a proposal in that you're interested in submitting a grant, submitting a proposal for it, an interest.
Letter of interest.
Letter of interest first, and then you've got 30 days. Once they agree that you're a viable candidate for funding, you have, what, 30 or 60 days to submit a proposal. So that's one, yeah, and they're in the range of 200 to, I think, 600,000, they've said.
And a lot of this narrative is already written from previous grant applications.
Right.
And they were well written. It was just that there was too much town governance going on in the
right.
building. So they said, you're not really a cultural facility.
Right.
But now
it's 100% cultural facility.
And there'll be sprinklers
in that.
No. Well, with the new water department, no.
No.
That's without sprinklers.
Yeah, that's not required, so they're not looking at that.
It's not required.
And the cost is excessive. High. But each of the four grants, what they're trying to do is group improvements in each of the four grants that would fund the majority of the projects. So like the cultural facilities, you could say you're doing all this work and only get 400,000, but you still got other work that's not funded. And there's a match for some of these. I think the cultural facility has a one-to-one match. So you've got to come up with a match as well. And there's some exclusions as to what funds can be used for the match. So I think the schedule is next spring to early summer is apply for all these grants, and then we should know by summertime, I guess, which ones we're getting, and then
summer, fall,
and then apply for whatever is remaining funding to town funds or CPA or whatever. So
could money from the cell tower go towards that, right?
Probably.
Good. Let's try for grants first.
Oh, absolutely. And well, of hard numbers.
Right.
So.
Being,
okay, Shane.
And you wouldn't want to bring that forward on the same meeting that the water merger process would be on, I wouldn't think.
I would agree.
Well, we're going to talk about it at the major projects. Session. I don't know if we're talking about the cost, but
pretty hard.
Yeah,
I don't think we run the risk of having them on the same town meeting.
That's good.
You know, I don't think the time.
No, we'll have it in the spring.
Right.
For a town hall, spring town. I don't think. No.
Okay. Another grant.
We're a year away from
that. All right. Okay. I would like to go into executive session for 10 minutes.
All right.
Before you do that, Comcast contract.
Yep. Oh yeah. We're getting close. I think I say that every time. But
my understanding is Deerfield
is going to. They have signed.
That was my understanding.
My understanding was that they're going to sign the 9th, but if they have signed.
Well, perhaps it's the 9th.
Earlier.
It was phrased that we're maybe ready to sign.
Okay. Paul, you can stick around if you want to.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can stick around if you want to.
Thank you. The other one, just this is a small one, I mentioned it to Brian. Conway is waiting for a refund on their contribution to the regional study that we all put in toward, the Frontier Regional Study.
Yeah, or the facility use.
Whatever,
yeah.
We hired UMass.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that got, I didn't hear any more about it, whether it got canceled, but they're after their money back.
Who is? Conway is?
Yeah.
I ran into him. Or did I? I had a conversation with somebody about this not too long ago, and we were going to be looking for. It was a big unknown essentially, as to what happened to it. Because it.
Yeah. No. Just I watched their meeting, and they put it in as money's coming back into their fund. Was the regional studies money's from the Frontier?
Because nothing was going to happen.
They didn't explain it. They just said money's were coming back in. Refunded the money.
so I don't know what happened.
Okay.
Let's look around. I'll check with Conway and see what.
Okay. Okay. Motion to adjourn? Oh, no, we need to.
Conway, so assuming you're.
To executive.
You're going into executive.
I'd like to.
But you need to read.
Read the reason here.
Number eight.
All you, Paul.
Chairman, Mr. Chairman.
Do you have your agenda still?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Aye. Brian's find it, okay. Very good, thank you. Roman Newhouse, let's see. To go into executive per MGL Chapter 30A, Section 21A, Subsection 6, to consider the lease of real estate if the chair declares that an open meeting may have a detrimental effect on the negotiating position of the public body. Board will not be returning to open session.
So roll call, vote call?
Yes.
Fred?
Yes.
Jonathan?
Yes.